Good morning, school. I'm here to talk about social media today. I would like to start with a case study of a very sad incident, the 2012 Amanda Todd case. Amanda Michelle Todd was a 15-year-old Canadian and a victim of cyberbullying. She hanged herself at a home in British Columbia. Before her death, Amanda posted a video on YouTube in which she shared her experience of being blackmailed into stripping on webcam, being physically assaulted and bullied. After her death, the video went viral and it has over 30 million views today. Yes, there have been several such unfortunate cases, and you may presume I'm here to talk about how terrible social media is. However, that is not what I'm going to do. In fact, I'm here to talk about how social media is a wonderful thing in our lives. Let me tell you what it is. Social media is a computer-mediated technology that helps us create and share information, ideas, and other forms of expression via virtual communities and networks. As of January 2019, we have a total population of over 7.676 billion people, out of which 3.256 billion people are social media users. That is about 42% of our total population. What makes social media the new guru? Social media makes communication easier and quicker. It also reaches a vast audience and helps create awareness better as compared to newspapers and letters. Social media can be used as a tool in education. It can be used to create multimodal content, build critical thinking, and it also extends discussions outside the classroom. Social media democratizes communication. Before, it was in the hands of only the media elite, the publishers, and the editors to tell us what was going on. But now, everyone can have the say. Social media can also be used to boost businesses. It can be used to market products, promote brands, and to connect current customers. So, what are the several threats we face on social media? Here's what you should look out for. One of the biggest issues of social media usage is addiction. As of 2018, over 210 million people on this planet are addicted to social media. Another issue of social media usage is stereotyping. Social media creates a stereotype of a perfect life, perfect body, perfect belongings, and perfect feeds. In this quest, we crave likes and attention. It puts teens under stress to look and behave a certain way. Anyone could be a victim of cyberbullying. You could be trolled for your views, your looks, or simply for no reason. Some cases are so extreme that leads to suicide. Social media could also prove to be hazardous for both mental and physical health. It leads to several mental health illnesses like depression, anxiety, and FOMO, that is, the fear of missing out. There are also directly related mental illnesses like depersonalization, that is, when a person is emotionally attached to social media. These become reasons for physical health issues as excessive social media usage makes us lazy, which leads to sedentary lifestyles, and it increases the risk of cardiac diseases. In this age of social media, we post our personal information very carelessly. We do not take in mind that we are exposing ourselves to the constant threat of stalkers, hackers, and people who may cause harm to us. Yes, so let me give you an example. It's like crossing a road and being run down by a car because we did not cross at a proper crossing. Does that mean we do not cross the road at all? It is not crossing the road that's the problem. It is not being aware of the traffic that's the problem. Same applies to the traffic on social media. Let me give you some good advice. Keep strong passwords, do not share personal information, and please be selective of friend requests. Here are a few more. The very first thing we learn as children is to socialize, and social media is helping us do it. Social media is not the threat. It is the people with bad intentions on social media. We may not be able to stop these bad people, but I'm sure we can learn to be safe and maintain distance from them. Maybe if Amanda had been more careful, she would have been alive today. In conclusion, I would like to say that social media usage doesn't always have to be negative. It depends on how you use it, for what purposes, and for how long. If used appropriately, it could be one of the greatest assets to humankind. I would like to leave you with the wise words of Erin Bury. Do not say anything online that you wouldn't want plastered on a billboard with your face on it. Thank you, and here are my sources.